Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me today is Mark Jensen, CEO at American Resources Corporation. Mark, great to see you. How are you?
Doing great, Christine. You?
I'm good. Thanks for asking. Mark, new developments today with your Wyoming County Coal Complex in terms of funding. Talk us through them.
Yeah, we're fortunate that we've been working with the state of West Virginia, as well as Citigroup, the underwriter, to pursue a tax-exempt bond issuance, which gives a substantial amount of funding. Got approved on Thursday for $45 million of tax-exempt bonds, which will be utilized to build an advanced carbon slash rare earth processing facility at our current site that we already own.
Why go this route in terms of funding? What's attractive about this avenue?
Yeah, I mean, it's a really long-term financing structure. It's pretty low cost because it's supported by the state. The state was looking at it because we're processing solid waste and repurposing it, extracting the rare earths out of it. And given the financing structure of the company, I mean, at the end of the day, we think our stock is really cheap and there's zero chance we're going to issue stock down here. Or we don't need to. We have plenty of cash on the balance sheet, but this just gives us that additional capital to really build this out in a way that can be extremely economical.
So how will you process the rare earths together with the coal at this particular plant?
That's what's awesome about it. So the United States government spent hundreds of millions of dollars researching rare earth elements from carbon-based deposits. The concentrates in carbon is pretty low, but when you tie it in with a carbon processing facility where you're already mining the carbon from metallurgical coal and the metallurgical carbon, which goes into steelmaking, you tie this directly in line with that, utilizing our mineral spirals and our electrolysis technology, in assistance with Texas Tech. We can basically utilize that byproduct economics to make money, not only on the carbon, but then also on the rare earth elements, so that when what your waste after that has been, all your good stuff's been all extracted from the product itself.
Right. So then you would then take the rare earths extracted at the Wyoming coal complex and then ship it over to Indiana.
That's exactly right. So we have we're utilizing now our capture and our process technology along with our chromatography technology, which is our purify technology. So we're building that site, still slated for a first quarter launch. And now we're going to be producing concentrates, not only from magnets and waste batteries, but now also from carbon-based deposits, and being able to basically get as many feedstocks as we possibly can to continue to fill this facility.
Any concerns at all about Omicron potentially being a disruptor in this at all?
No, we work and we have a lot of procedures put in place to keep our employees safe. And ultimately it's where we're building this, that's a pretty rural area and our guys work outside. So thankfully with our procedures and policies, I mean, the demand for met carbon is really strong right now. And obviously we're going to be the first company in the U.S. to purify and isolate rare earths. There's the growth for the rare earth market and the battery metals market is so strong right now that there's no way we're going to get derailed in our opinion.
All right. Looking forward to following progress here, Mark. If I don't see you before, happy holidays. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. You too.